What's up, guys? It's Tom. Welcome back to another video. About 6 weeks ago, I posted a video about how to connect your passive studio monitors to your audio interface. I talked about how I did that in my studio, some of the tools and the tricks that I use to make it easy. And in the comments of that video, I had several people ask me, how do you connect more than one set of monitors to your interface? Specifically, I had questions about how to connect a subwoofer in addition to your pair of monitors. I had a question about how to connect a passive pair of monitors and an active set of monitors where you can switch easily between the two at the same time. This video is a follow-up to that video to answer that very question. I want to share with you how I solve that problem in my studio. Specifically for me, I have a subwoofer connected along with my pair of NS10s, but I have the ability to add on another pair of monitors if I want to with my setup. And sometimes I do that for mix referencing. You can kind of go all across the board with this. You can get something like the Mackie Big Knob, the Behringer Minimon down on the lower price range end of things, or you can go up to the Personas Central Station Plus, or all the way up to the Dangerous Music Monitor ST. And there are plenty of other options aside from just those that are in the market. Those are just the ones that I want to highlight in this video. So all the way down to the Behringer unit, you can find used for about 30 bucks on Reverb, or you can go brand new with the Dangerous Music unit all the way up to 2,000 bucks. Me, I don't use any of those. The unit I use is called the Samson C-Control Control Room Matrix. The reason I haven't included it in that list to begin with is that it is discontinued, but you can find this unit on Reverb used, I think, for about 40 bucks, at least as of the time of filming this video. So they are out there, they're just not new. But you can probably find one in pretty good condition if you are willing to do the legwork. Now, as you can see, there's not a whole lot to this little unit. This is the Samson C-Control. This is what I use. It is a tiny little thing. It fits right on my desk. It just goes right into the corner of my desk, and it has a whole lot of options that you can do with it from just two channels from your main interface. You can add four inputs, four stereo inputs. You have the option for three stereo outputs. You have three speaker options, and you have a cue out for your talkback, a remote talkback switch if you want to use a foot switch to control your talkback for your session. The way I use it is I have two channels coming in to two track A or mix in. It really doesn't matter which one you want to put it into. Just make sure that the right one is selected on the front of the unit. And then I have speaker A going out into my preamp, my CLA 200, which powers my Yamaha NS10s. Then I have in speaker B, a stereo RCA output into a just little old boombox. I check my mixes in mono through just a regular old boombox because most people are not listening to your music on high fidelity systems. They're listening on pretty cheap systems. So it's a good reference point to have. And then I use the speaker C output to take a stereo send and sum it into mono into my subwoofer. And I'm able to toggle on and off which speakers I want to use and easily switch between any set of speakers that I'm using for my mix. It's a really, really easy, simple piece of gear. I just set mine in the corner of my desk and it solves all of my problems for this. And that's it. It's really simple, really easy to set up. Just two channels into whichever one you choose from your audio interface, and it will split the signal from there depending on what you want to do with it. I highly recommend looking into this if you have this problem. I think monitoring on multiple speakers is very, very helpful for your mixes. I'm going to include links below in this video to somewhere to buy all of these different units I've mentioned if you want to check them out, or if you want to Google studio monitor control room solutions or control room matrix or studio monitor management. Those are all search terms that will help you find a solution to this problem. So this is just what I use. There are a lot of options out there, but I hope this helps. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will catch you on the next one. Peace.